Now in class 11th, I have a topic to tell you, the tangential and centripetal accelerations. This topic is very important because every year some numerical question is asked in the medical entrance examination and other examinations also. So you watch the video completely and try to understand how to find the centripetal acceleration and the tangential acceleration and what is the resultant of these two, and also how to calculate them if the question, numerical question, is given in the exam. So I take this tangential and the centripetal acceleration. Now we know that V equal to omega cross R. This we know. This is the relationship between the linear velocity and angular velocity and the radius vector. So now we have to find the acceleration. Differentiating with respect to time, what we get? We get this dv upon dt is equal to d upon dt omega cross r, omega cross. So this is equal to omega cross dr upon dt plus, this is now your d omega upon dt into r. So this is what, if we take this omega cross, this is now velocity, plus this is alpha cross R. This is equal to acceleration A, dv upon dt, acceleration A. Now this term, A is equal to, this is now your AC, plus this is now your AT. This is knowledge, where AC equal to omega cross V, and this is equal to V square upon R. So this is the centripetal acceleration. Centripetal acceleration. And AT, this is equal to alpha cross R. So this is equal to R alpha. This is now AT. So this is AC. This is now your AC. This is so much. Now we have brought the vectors, so we have given the magnitude, then this is equal to so much. And this is equal to what? The tangential acceleration. I have told you about the centripetal acceleration that is always directed towards the center of the circular path. Tangential acceleration, as the name suggests, this is along the radius, this is along the tangent drawn at the point on the circular path. So both are mutually perpendicular. AC and AT are mutually perpendicular. Are mutually perpendicular. So how to show this in the circular motion? This is suppose the circular path. O is the radius, the center, and the particle is moving like this, anticlockwise. And suppose the particle is here, and we draw a tangent. This is what? AT. AT. Acting along the tangent at the point P. And in this direction, we are having AC. AC. This is AC. AC. PO direction. In PO direction. So these are mutually perpendicular. So what we have? If we complete this, like we are having to, we can make this is AT and this is AC, then just you complete to this one and we have this, the A. This is A, the total or the resultant acceleration. And let this angle is theta. So what we have? Where A equal to resultant acceleration. So now you can see from here that this A equal to square root of AC square plus AT square. This is the resultant of this AC and AT. You know what is this? Theta. Tan theta equal to AT upon AC, perpendicular upon base. So theta equal to what? Theta equal to tan inverse AT upon AC. This is the angle. So both these AT and AC are mutually perpendicular. I am telling here, if you draw at any other point, the similar situation will be, this AC will always directed towards the center and AT that will be along the tangent drawn at the point of the circular path. Now one thing you remember, for uniform circular motion, what we have? Speed equal to constant and this omega equal to constant. So this angular acceleration alpha, this is equal to 0. It means what? That this AT will be equal to 0. So this for this one, therefore this AT, this is equal to 0. So when the particle undergoes a uniform circular motion, the tangential acceleration is always 0. Then we are having only the center. The resultant acceleration A, this is equal to AC. and this is equal to v square upon r, this is equal to a. इस समय केवल सेंट्रिपेटल एक्सेलरेशन होता है, इसमें टेंजेंशियल एक्सेलरेशन नहीं होता। अब सपोज दिस सर्कुलर मोशन इज नॉट यूनिफॉर्म फॉर नॉन यूनिफॉर्म सर्कुलर मोशन स्पीड इज नॉट इक्वल टू कॉन्स्टेंट, तो इसमें क्या होता है, स्पीड बढ़ती जाती है। तो क्वेश्चन में क्या दिया होता है, द स्पीड ऑफ द पार्टिकल इंक्रीज एट द रेट ऑफ 5 meters per second और 2 meters per second, देन दिस इज द at, because we are given that the velocity or the speed of the particle increases at the rate, what is the language, at the rate of 5 meters per second. So at the rate of 5 meters per second means this is the tangential acceleration. So in that case the velocity is not constant, then the angular velocity is also not constant, then alpha is not equal to zero. In that case, there will exist the tangential acceleration. For speed, and this omega is not equal to constant. So angular acceleration alpha, this is not equal to zero. So the tangential acceleration at, this is equal to rl, this is not equal to zero. So whenever we are having the non uniform circular motion, then we are having both kind of the accelerations in non uniform circular motion. The centripetal and tangential accelerations both at तो दोनों ही साथ साथ काम करते हैं, और अगर ये नहीं है तो दोनों साथ साथ काम नहीं करेंगे। सो दिस इज व्हाट दैट वी आर हैविंग दिस वन। सो रिमेंबर दैट व्हेन एवर यू आर गिवन ऑर्डर, देन द क्वेश्चन इज दैट एक्चुअली दिस वी स्क्वायर अपॉन आर, व्हेन द वेलोसिटी इज गिवन, then you can find this AC equal to V square upon R. But there is one another way of finding the tangential acceleration. I will give you some note for this. if it is given in question. That velocity of particle changes at the rate of v, say 5 meters per second. Then tangential acceleration PT is equal to V meter per second square. Or this is equal to now 5 meter per second square. तो हम ये मान लेंगे आपको ये दे दिया गया है कि भाई the velocity of the particle changes at the rate of v meter per second. V meter per second. और हमने मान लिया कि ये 5 meter per second के हिसाब से कहता है. तो 5 meter per second के हिसाब से कह रहा है. It means ये क्या है? Tangential acceleration है. वो ये है आपका. 5 मीटर पर सेकंड स्क्वायर. अब इसी से आपको v का मान ये दिया गया है कि इससे आप सेंट्रिपेटल एक्सेलरेशन निकाल सकते हैं. सो सेंट्रिपेटल एक्सेलरेशन ac इक्वल टू b स्क्वायर अपॉन v का मान आपको ये दिया होगा. r आपको दिया जाएगा रेडियस क्या है इसके ऊपर बात की. तो इससे आप ac का मान निकाल लेंगे. देन यू फाइंड द रिजल्टेंट. तो रिजल्टेंट कब निकालेंगे? ये तभी निकालेंगे जब आपको नॉन यूनिफॉर्म सर्कुलर मोशन दिया होगा. इफ दिस इज नॉट दिस इज गिवन द यूनिफॉर्म सर्कुलर मोशन देन देयर विल बी ओनली द सेंट्रीपेटल एक्सेलरेशन. देयर इज another way of finding this center in this tangential acceleration. If kinetic energy is given, then W equal to delta K. W is what? Force into acceleration. Now force into displacement x. This is equal to the kinetic energy is given. So this is now half m square. This is equal to delta k. Then f equal to m into at into x. This is equal to delta k. इसमें x आपको दिया गया होगा, x दिया गया होगा कि कितना डिस्प्लेसमेंट उसमें होता है. तो दिस x को हम कैसे निकाल सकते हैं? बॉडी कैसे मूव कर रही है? दिस इज मूविंग लाइक दिस. दिस इज नॉट सेंटर. बॉडी इज मूविंग लाइक दिस. देन दिस इज नॉट. दिस इज x. This angle is theta. You are given the angular displacement. Then you have to find the x. So this to find the x is how much? This theta equal to x upon r, r the radius. This is our radius. R upon radius. X upon r. So this is now is so much. So in place of x, you can write down this theta into r. So this m into at into this is equal to what? Theta r. This is equal to delta t. Now find this tangential axis. AT equal to delta k upon m theta into r. Theta into r. This is not so much. So अगर आपको kinetic energy दी गई है और angular displacement दिया गया है तो आप इससे भी इसका मान निकाल सकते हैं. ये भी इसका निकालने का तरीका है. दूसरा तरीका एक में तीसरा तरीका इसमें होता है थर्ड मेथड दैट सिंस दिस टेंजेंशियल एक्सेलरेशन इज इक्वल टू आर इनटू अल्फा. तो सपोज आपको टाइम दिया गया कि ये इतने डिस्प्लेसमेंट आपको दिया गया कि इतना डिस्प्लेसमेंट होता है. सो यू कैन यूज द इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन फॉर सर्कुलर मोशन. सो दैट इज व्हाट दिस ओमेगा इक्वल टू ओमेगा नॉट प्लस अल्फा टी और थीटा इक्वल टू ओमेगा नॉट टी प्लस हाफ अल्फा टी स्क्वायर और ओमेगा स्क्वायर इक्वल टू ओमेगा नॉट स्क्वायर प्लस टू अल्फा थीटा. तो अल्फा कैन बी फाइंड आउट the angular acceleration can be calculated by using equation of motions. Equations of motion like this omega equal to omega naught plus alpha t, theta equal to omega naught t plus half alpha t square, omega square equal to omega naught t plus 2 alpha theta. By using this you can find the value of alpha where omega naught, this is what the initial angular action, angular velocity, and this omega is equal to final angular velocity. And this theta is equal to angular displacement and t the time. So if some of the quantities are given in the question, then you can also calculate the value of alpha from these equations. So if और इसे जब अल्फा पता हो व्हेन यू फाइंड दिस अल्फा देन यू कैलकुलेट द टेंजेंशियल एक्सेलरेशन. कैलकुलेट टेंजेंशियल एक्सेलरेशन ए टी इक्वल टू एल्फ R L R L. ठीक है. तो क्या करेंगे अल्फा यहां से निकाल लेंगे. आर की वैल्यू आपको दी गई होगी तो यहां से भी आप ए टी का मान निकाल सकते हैं. तो दीज आर द डिफरेंट वेज टू फाइंड आउट द दिस टेंजेंशियल एक्सेलरेशन. So remember that these methods can be applied. The centripetal acceleration निकालने में कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं होती, वो तुरंत निकल जाए. स्पीड दी गई है, रेडियस दी गई है, निकालने में कितना होता है. बट टेंजेंशियल एक्सेलरेशन निकालने के लिए आपको इस तरीके से आपको करना पड़ेगा. दीज मेथड्स आर टू बी यूज्ड. सो ऑल ऑफ यू वॉच दिस वीडियो कंप्लीटली, ओनली देन यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड और ऑल्सो यू फाइंड सम न्यूमेरिकल क्वेश्चन ऑन दिस बेसिस एंड ट्राई टू सॉल्व देम. इफ यू हैव एनी काइंड ऑफ डिफिकल्टी then you write down in the comment box. I will answer your difficulty. Thank you.